Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn about how to add a predefined strategy in Strategy Manager. As the name suggests, Strategy Manager is all about tracking the P&L of your strategy, setting alerts and looking at the Greeks for the strategy, which can help you manage the strategy better. We'll click on Strategy Manager. And we can see that we have a tab of add position. We'll click on that, which prompts us to select whether we want to add a predefined strategy or we want to add a custom one. For now, we'll select a predefined strategy. It's asking us to enter the symbol, so we'll select Nifty. We'll click on next. Then it is asking us to choose a direction. What kind of a strategy I want to add? Let's say I want to add a bullish strategy. Now again we have a sorting available, whether we want to add a limited risk strategy or we want to look at all the strategies. We'll click on limited risk strategy and we can see that now we have a list of strategy available within bullish with a limited risk profile. Let's say we want to do a bull call spread, so we'll click on that. We can see that the tool has automatically selected a bull call spread nearest to the current market price. If you want to change the strike, we can scroll up and down by clicking on the strike panel and we can change it. So let's say we want to do a 10,500 to 10,600 bull call spread. So the first leg is a buy and the second leg is a sell. I can directly click on fetch CMP. If I want the CMP to be auto-populated, if I want to enter something manually, I can also go ahead and do that. If you want to change the lots, you can click on the lots and you can change this value as well. Let's say if I want to do two lot multiple of the strategy, I can just write two and update, which makes the quantity 150 buy and 150 sell. We can see that the tool has automatically given it a name, bull call spread, but if you want to give a custom one, you can do that. We can flag this trade as traded or tracking, which can help us segregate the P&L when we are tracking it, which we'll see shortly. We'll go ahead and save the strategy. As we do that, now it is asking us whether I want to set an alert on the strategy or not. So let's say we want to do that. I'll click on set alert. And I'll say, let me know whenever I make 1000 rupees profit in the strategy or else whenever the P&L goes below minus 500. Please note, if you want to enter a negative P&L, you should include the minus sign. The reason of doing this is that if I already am making profit in one of the strategy and I want to know whenever the P&L is going below a level which is positive, this will also allow me to do that. But if you are entering a stop loss, ideally it should be minus and then the value. We'll go ahead and save this. And it says that the alert has been successfully saved. And this brings us to the strategy. If we note here, it is saying that I have a loss of 1935. How is that possible? Because I have just added the strategy and there could not be a loss. But what has happened here is that we have traded on the bid and ask and the evaluation here happens on the last traded price. So this is basically the slippage value that will occur in your P&L because of the difference between the bid and ask and the LTP. All mark to market settlement will happen on the closing price, which is this P&L. If I want to know the detail of the strategy, I'll click on that. And I can see that now I have the complete detail of the strategy where it says me that the margin for this strategy is 1,20,960. The return on investment so far is minus 1.6%. The ATM volatility is 11.47 and I have set an alert above 1000 rupees and below 500 rupees. In the next panel, it shows us how the Greeks are placed. So this is showing me the delta, the theta, the vega and the gamma value, which can help me understand the strategy better if I have to tweak it. If you look below, it also tells us the leg-wise PNL and the leg-wise Greek. If I want to understand, let's say, which is the strategy which is giving me net vega positive, I can see that the first leg is the one which has a vega of 569. This helps you analyze the strategy better. Now, if I have to see more detail about the strategy as to what is the sensitivity to volatility or what is the sensitivity to the time, I can click on analyze. As we do that, we can see that it has brought us to the expiry payoff. On the day of expiry, which is 3 days from now, my strategy will have a payoff like this. But if I want to see what happens on the second day, I can just click on and I can scroll this navigation bar, and this brings me to the second day PNL. I can change the volatility and see how much is the impact. Let's say what happens if the volatility of the entire strikes goes up by 5%. Then we have the revised PNL here. To look at the PNL, I can click on the chart, which gives me the PNL level. If you want to look at the level in the PNL together, you can do a long press that brings a panel which shows you the level and the PNL at the same time. You can also click on view table if you want a tabulation view for this, where the level and the PNL is visible. So this is all about adding a predefined strategy in Strategy Manager.